Du hast nicht die leiseste Ahnung.
In Istanbul, or at least visiting on a vacation in Turkey with her boyfriend, who is a photographer there. There is the bridge where we saw an explosion just moments ago. Fareed, don't go anywhere, Catherine. Do you recognize this bridge?
Yeah. This is Istanbul. What's extraordinary is you normally see this bridge. It is packed with traffic. Traffic in Istanbul is usually among the worst in the world. And you can see, of course, a very different picture. And you can see some, you know, there's smoke still rising out of there from there.
Let's listen for a little bit. Catherine, don't go anywhere. Fareed either. Let's listen in.
Adamın bacağı falan popmuş ya orada patlamada.
So Catherine, this is relatively calm to what we witnessed, you know, just a short time ago. It unfolded in darkness, but still, it is unnerving to hear explosions and to see a city that usually has some normalcy right now. And as Fareed Zakaria said, packed with cars. You see no traffic in one direction and the traffic backed up trying to get to that bridge. It is unnerving.
It is. And I've been coming here. I'm actually working here as well. I have clients here. I've been coming to Turkey for over 10 years. Normally at this time, it's very touristy, lots of people. We haven't seen any Americans. We were out today, actually, in the old city, and it seemed very empty. The hotel is very empty. And we've been trying to get through to the embassy. We cannot reach the embassy through any of the numbers. So we're very concerned about getting out because we're supposed to leave tomorrow. But as you know, the airports are shut down.
Mm. If you're just joining us here on CNN, we're watching, we believe that is the aftermath of a coup. And I say believe it is the aftermath because we're not exactly sure if the coup is over. We're being told by government officials, at least pro-Erdogan officials, that this coup is over. It was an unsuccessful coup. But again, still much more is going to be needed for confirmation that this was an unsuccessful coup. It's interesting because the deputy prime minister joined us just a short time ago, Mehmet Şimşek, here on CNN, saying that there were rogue aircraft who were firing at the parliament in Ankara. An eyewitness there just moments ago, Diego Cupolo, said he heard some of it. He saw some of it posted. And he also saw that aircraft and at least the firing, not exactly at the parliament, but firing in places in Ankara as well. The images that you're looking at now are images that were taken during the height of this, but we've also just gotten live pictures moments ago that came in from Istanbul, and you can see there was an explosion in those pictures near a bridge. Also, here we go with more live pictures. This is from Istanbul as well, people out on the streets. Of course, the president, during the height of this, the president Erdogan encouraging people, really pleading with them to go out on the streets and to take back Turkey and to take back their streets and to take back their government, even people who may not have been pro-government, at least pro-this government, but they are pro-democracy, doing exactly what Erdogan said. And as a number of officials have told us here on CNN, that it appeared to be successful, that helped the situation, Fareed Zakaria, as we look at these live pictures.
Yeah, and it's very important to note that the opposition party, the Republican Party, actually supported Erdogan and said, we do not support a coup. Mm-hmm. Many people in the media in Turkey have done the same thing. What, as you say, though, it's still striking that you do not have President Erdogan, obviously does not feel comfortable coming out, doing some kind of a public statement, you know, speaking from one of the presidential palaces. There's an official residence of the president in Istanbul, a very grand one that I've been to. There's, of course, a palatial one in Ankara. The fact that he is still not, you know, accessible easily on media, that you still don't have the head of the armed forces coming out and denouncing this coup, that tells us there's still a great deal of fluidity to this situation.
Catherine, tell us, as an American, what is it like surviving this, living through this?
Well, I've been frightened. We've been very, very scared. And I travel all over the globe for my work, and I'm often in the Middle East, and I'm never scared. And this is the first time I've really been scared. So, you know, we've just been up all night listening to this. It feels like there's a war zone outside. We're very lucky to have shelter and to be in our hotel. But we're on lockdown here. Mm-hmm. We can't get out. They're not letting people out. Even the people, when we came in, you know, people who are here having dinner, wanting to go home, and they weren't letting people out. The military had basically shut the hotel down. They couldn't even send a car for us. We were out in a totally different neighborhood to get us back here. So we had to find our way back, which was an adventure in itself. It took us about an hour to get back here. We couldn't find a taxi. We jumped in the civilian car. This gentleman was so kind to take us part of the way, but then the streets were shut down, and we ended up walking and finally getting in. So we feel, you know, luckily relatively safe right now, but it's going on all outside, right in front of us and overhead.
Yeah.
It's so close.
You said you were frightened for your life, and we heard the same stories coming into us last night in Nice, France, now this happening in Turkey. Thank you, Catherine Cohen. She's in an American hotel in Istanbul, CEO, by the way, and founder of Ivywise. They're on business, and her boyfriend is there as well, surviving this coup in a hotel. Fareed Zakaria is here. Fareed is going to continue to join me for a bit here on CNN to help guide us through this. Up next, and by the way, I want to say that you're looking at live pictures. These are live pictures now coming in from Periscope, Istanbul, 5:45 in the morning as the sun comes up there. Up next, more on our breaking news coverage of the coup attempt in Turkey.
All new Inside Africa.